everyone, today we'll be discussing about the network architecture evolution. How the network evolved, it's nothing but when it was to be introduced and how the architectural concept came into effect. It will be determined in this particular session. So telegraph network, it is nothing but how the messages were transmitted from one end to another end and how digitally they were said to be transmitted. Digitally means what? Earlier in the beginning it was through the wired lines carry what? It's like electricity was said to be concerned in the most important factor, where electricity, when it is said to be flowing, then it is one. If it is not flowing, then it is said to be zero. So that concept was introduced in the beginning only, where you can see here telegraph network, it is nothing but how it was introduced. As you have the concept of telegraph network, which had the message switching and even the digital transmission. Digital transmission, it's nothing but, as I said, the electricity was the most important aspect which was said to be used in transmission. Then after telegraph came the telephone network. It is nothing but it has the circuit switching concept, like one circuit to another circuit. Okay, when it is said to be transmitting, a circuit used to be designed. So from one circuit to another circuit, it had to transmit the data. So that concept, it was involved in the telephone network. Then analog to digital transmission came. Analog is nothing but when you are said to be in the format of waves, then it is said to be analog. This analog signals were transmitted and it was changed to the digital concept. It had the wave pulse, that is when it is low it is zero, when it is high it is said to be one. Like that the digital concept was said to be introduced. After that it came with the mobile communication. Everything, whatever the data was to be sent, it was in the concept of mobile used to carry the information from one in a fraction of seconds. You are said to be messaging, you are calling, everything. So that concept came after the telegraph, it came the telephone network. Next came about the concept of your packet switching and computer applications and internet. It's nothing but packet switching is nothing but your data. Whatever data it is there, it will be in the format of packets. Okay, small packets it will be concerned into and it will be divided into. So when it is said to be transmitting your data, it will be in packets. As I said, it will be in the small packets format, and that packets used to be multiple packets. Your data was said to be transmitted from one end to another end. Okay, so computer application, it's nothing but whatever your packets were said to be designed, it had to be in the format of computer applications format. Okay, when you are said to be transmitting the data from one end to another end, a software was to be involved which will convert your whole data into some other meaningful data. Then it was said to be used with the concept of computer application. Next came the next generation internet, which had the concept of which used to provide multiple services at a time. Multiple services is whatever data is there, it has to be transmitted in fraction of seconds, plus it has to be involved with all types of data has to be transmitted. It may be digital, it may be audio, it may be video, all types, everything. It is in the format of your new generation interconnect concept. Whatever nowadays you are sort of using, your new generation, it has the concept of your multi-service packet switching. Okay, so everything one by one it was said to be dealt. One is telegraph network, telephone network, internet, and your next generation internet. And that was said to be involved. Okay, so next we will be moving on one by one the various approaches, okay, of communication. You can see here one of the approaches, as you see now also, it is said to be courier. Courier, it is nothing but your message, it will be sent via a person, or it may be earlier stages, in the beginning they used to use the animals to convey the messages. For example, you have the pigeons, those which help to carry the message from one end to another end. And you have the all other various concepts of messengers. You have Phonex Express, FedEx, you have DFHL, all are said to be your communication networks which were said to be used. Okay, now another concept which is there in the telegraphic concept is nothing but I want to transmit the data over the network signals. Okay, I want to send the information from one end to another end. How do I send the information? Earlier in the beginning, how it was, you had to convey a message to whole city or your whole village. Then they used to have the drums. For example, they used to use the drums. Okay, when the drums were beaten, all the people used to gather. Beacons are nothing but message conveying devices. Then you have the mirrors which convey some message. Like if signals were sent through the mirrors, then you have the smoke. Smoke means what? If something happens in the city, a smoke was being there. Then the flags. Flags depict something. Okay, when it is flying high, a message may be there. When the flag is down, it used to convey some message. Then you have the semaphores. Next, you will be dealing with that semaphore. It had this hands which will like show the direction. That was there. Then electricity was one of the concept of communication. Then you had the light. Light also is a kind of communication. Then many other telegraphic messages were said to be dealt, and they were said to be used to convey some message to the other end. So earlier it was various devices which were used to communicate. So how these operate and what are the importance in the communication aspect, you will be learning today. So next, in the concept, you have the optical telegraph. Optical telegraph, as we discussed, they used to use a semaphore. Semaphore is nothing but, here you can see you have the hands which will depict some signals. Okay, signals means what? When the hands are said to be higher, they meant had a certain meaning. When they were down, it had certain meaning. Mainly it was said to be introduced in 1790s by the Claude Chappe. Okay, he had introduced this semaphore concept. They mimicked the person, like a person, how a person, he gives a signal through his hands or something. Same way the semaphores were designed which give the signals. Outstretched arms were there which used to convey some message. Then each arms, they used to depict one or the other message. They used to give 100 number of signals. Okay, and these encrypted messages were said to be kept secret. Whatever it was, the message, the person who was said to be dealing it, that person only was said to be knowing. Okay, those arms or the signals, what do they mean? It was said to be kept secret. And this arms, they used to propagate the message for a longer distance. The distance was about 800 kilometers in 3 minutes. It used to carry, okay, 3 minutes. In 3 minutes, it covered about 800 kilometers, the semaphore, and it gave the message nearby to the people who are around that 800 kilometers. Okay, this was the concept of your optical telegraph, which gave certain meanings with through their signals. Now, in the concept of network only, the next concept is said to be having the message switching. Switching is nothing but, it had the concept of dotted things. It's nothing but, each dot is nothing but conveying of message from one dot to another dot. Is one place to another place, it is said to be conveying some message. Okay, it was said to be introduced in the Paris, this method. It had the concept of store and forward operation. It used each node, whatever dots are there, dots depict the nodes. Each node, it used to store the information and pass on to the next one. Nothing but, it used to know, okay, where to jump, how to jump, and where to reach out with the destination, to which place the message had to be conveyed. That message which was said to be conveyed, it was through handheld. Okay, I had to move the data from one end to another end. It was given from one hand to another hand, one hand to another hand. Like that, the convey of message was there until the operator, okay, who is said to be conveying the message, he gets the information and the other person will be receiving the information. Like that, the store and forward operation was said to be introduced. I get the information, I store it and pass on to the next one. Then another person, he passes on to the next one. The both of them, they used to know the address whom to convey the message. Like that, it was there in the message switching concept. Okay, it was there in the message switching concept. Okay, next, it was there in the electric telegraph. Electric telegraph, it's nothing but, it had a concept which of dots and dashes. Okay, it was said to be introduced in 1837 by Samuel Morse. It's nothing but, it had the concept of dots and dashes. Each wire, it carried about a signal. Okay, dots and dashes, it had to convey. A dot means what? It had some meaning, and the dash had its own meaning. So it represented mainly the alphabets, and it used to carry the current signals over that particular things. And it was said to be introduced over like it used to carry about miles, it's nothing but 1840 kilometers it used to carry, nothing but 40 miles is nothing but 1840 kilometers this signal was to carry it from one end to another, and it had the electric current which used to flow through the copper wires. Here also it had the concept of storing and forwarding, stores the data and forwards the data, but each signal it represented certain codings. Okay, that codings, next slide it is there. So here modern digital, it used to convey the information related to your digital concept, how the data used to transfer. When a data had to be transferred, the electricity used to run. If the data was not said to be transferred, means what? The electricity was not flowing. Then this, the conveying of message, it was approximately equal to 2 into 108 meters per second over the cable it used to carry the signal. Okay, so this was the electric telegraph of Samuel Morse. Morse code table, it is here, you can see here the alphabets, they represent their own things. A means dot and dash, B means dash and three dots, C means dash dot dash dot, like that each alphabet had its own coding in the Morse code. Okay, each depicted its own code when it is said to be carrying from one end to another end. Then the electric telegraph network, this also had the concept of information which was said to be flown in the Samuel Morse code only. What it was depicting is, like, it had the concept of message switching, it had the concept of storing and forwarding operation, and it had three main key elements in it. What are the three main key elements are addressing? Okay, when I am transmitting the data, I need the address where to transmit. Then routing is nothing but routing, where, in which route it has to flow the data. Okay, I know the address, but which route to flow. Then forwarding is nothing but, okay, when I get the data, main thing is I forward to the next one. Okay, the other person forwards to the other one. Person maybe, or it may be a device. What does it do? Mainly gets the data, transfer, gets the data and transfer. That it was done through a route and through the address from one end to another end to propagate. Mainly this optical telegraph, it was like disappeared later because of the invention of this electric telegraph network. Okay, mainly this disappeared because of this concept only, that the signals, giving the signals through hands or through a device, it was difficult. So it had the concept of electric concept which will flow the data from one end to another end. It had the concept of store and forward, but it was through the nodes or the devices which were there, which will carry the information from one end to another end and depict certain messages to the other end. So in the previous stages it was a different one, and nowadays it is said to be a different one, where everything it has taken over by the electric concept. Like your data will be transferred from one end to another in fraction of seconds due to its electrical factors. Okay, so this concept is the given more importance on evolution of the network, how it was introduced earlier and how it has grown so much. The network, it has grown too much to the extent that it is said to be following your data, or it is said to be moving your data in a fraction of seconds. That is the difference between earlier stage and nowadays. Okay, thank you.